With that, I'll close it, and I'll open for any public comment. Name, address for the record.
Kurt Schultz, 2027 Tanglewood Drive. I'm sure everyone in here pretty much knows about the farmer's market. We're in full swing now. There's great vegetables out there. Just today, we had some of the best melon ever tasted for breakfast. Watermelon for dinner, along with, what else? We have great tomatoes. But anyway, another aspect of the farmer's market. Last year, we got into the tail end of a national contest in the last month, and we ended up coming in second in the state behind Peachtree Road Farmer's Market. And we were pretty proud of ourselves, but anyway, this year we got in from day one into this contest, and as of right now, we are number one in our size category in the country. Anyway, we want to stay in that position. If we win the contest for the country, we get all kinds of great PR for the city. We get tote bags for the vegetables with, you know, the name on it, being number one and all this stuff. But anyway, all I'm asking, if anybody hasn't voted yet in the contest, please meet me after the meeting, give me your email address and name. I will enter the votes. And hopefully, in six more weeks, we're going to be number one. We're fighting off farmers market from New York right now. They're in second place behind us. And just for the record, also, Mr. Mayor, I want to make sure you know that I don't know how to text or send emails on my phone, so please take me off your investigation list for the day. Thank you.
Hold on. Okay. Any other citizens wish to comment? I'll need your name and address for the record.
Dennis Lawton, 3041 Ellis Bridge Way. I stand before you tonight disappointed in the fact of how Mr. Spahn said there was good discussion, which I agree with. But unfortunately, I sat out in the audience and didn't understand very much of it, because the figures that you tried to present to us were hearsay, back and forth, except for the presentation that was done originally. There was questions asked, what was this, what was that? Nobody gave me an answer of how many dollars are we saving on, how many dollars, and yet you made a decision tonight on something that, yes, Mayor, you're correct that there was lowering, or all of two of the lowering, one was going to raise it. That's all we got out of when we finally made that comment. But the figures back and forth were kind of misleading to us as the citizens for directing us to what you are. I don't know right now what your budget is. Other than, okay, 5.9, what was that dollars? You know, what is that? That wasn't there to put in there as final figures. You know, when you make a decision of this importance on property taxes and on your budget, you made a decision several weeks ago to need so much money. But to make this decision on the millage rate seemed to be very total confusion. Three of you had ideas of this, and yet the other ones, you're asking this, and $320,000 was thrown out one time, $219,000, $128,000, yet we don't know. And I don't think that's the way to do it when you're talking about the money of all the citizens to make up that type of budget, other than, at this point. So I was very disappointed to see that we couldn't come up with the figures and come up with and say, okay, we've got to pay a recess, and Mr. Treadway, give me some figures and put it down there so you can post it or give me the exact figures, not roundabouts and whatever it is. And if you needed time with other opponents or whatever it is to get some of these figures. Now we've thrown it back into, as it turns out, a decision by the law rather than by individuals. And that's the simple case. We don't know whether 5.7 is right. We don't know whether 5.9 is right. Or we don't know what 6.19 is right, because we're going 94.5, 93.5, don't do it right, especially in this type of situation, then I think that's really a very important decision on the council's part to tell us to set a millage rate. So I was disappointed to see it was 3-3, 3-3, and while it means nothing, why didn't you just forget the vote tonight and say, well, it's 5.9? Because that's what you came up with, is what it was in before. So we just didn't do anything. Maybe we could have just left it and say, we're just not going to do any changes to the millage rate this year, and made it very simple. So I appreciate a little bit more communications. We got work sessions? I didn't hear anything about the work sessions.
Thank you, Mr. Lawton. I saw a gentleman in the back. Forward and state your name and address for the record.
My name's Tim Roth. I'm one of your newest business members here.
I'll need your address, please.
2305 Scenic Highway. I don't live in Snellville, but I own a business here. And several of you got an email from me this week regarding the gaming machines. The gaming machines, while they're not illegal, the payouts that these stores are doing are. And I'm trying to ask that y'all do something about them, because I can't be pleased. They're making $5,000 to $10,000 a month, they with the profits. So they're out of the gas possible at low cost, and I can't compete. Either that or give me special permission to do the same thing they're doing. And I just wanted to come introduce myself tonight, and when I come back next meeting, I'll have a little more practice and figures for you.
Sure. I want to comment with Chief Roy Whitehead, our chief police back there. Uh-huh. What I would suggest is that you meet with the chief and talk about that, because he's the enforcement officer. That would be the first step.
And then I've talked to the GBI, governor's office, and they've all referred me around and around. We've got no way.
Well, we stumble the chief police. Knows what's going on.
So. All right.
Anybody else wish to speak? Seeing none, I'll close the public comment. I believe that's everything on the agenda. Am I correct? All right, with that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn the meeting.
So moved.
A motion by Mr. Savaz, or second? Second by Ms. Capps. All those in favor of the motion, signify by raising the right hand. We're adjourned. See you all in 2 weeks. Have a safe trip.